Welcome to the special report on COVID-19, brought to you by CNA TV.
Welcome to the NACA COVID-19 report. I'm your host, Dane Henning. As of March 30th, more than 400 of 15,000 U.S. nursing facilities had an outbreak of coronavirus among residents, staff, or both, according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the CDC. There are indications, however, that those reports dramatically understate the situation. Minnesota, one of the few states publicly disclosing outbreaks in care facilities, reported 42 facilities with COVID-19 on April 4th. This despite a relatively low infection rate among its overall population. It is likely that COVID-19 is far more widespread in U.S. facilities. According to one report, 90% of care facilities in Belgium have reported cases. Last week, we discussed McKnight's long-term care news reporting that nearly half of nursing homes it surveyed reported COVID-19-related illness among its staff. Those still working struggle with shortages of masks, gloves, and gowns. These shortages appear to be even more serious than in hospitals. Most facilities still have no access to test kits for staff, patients, or residents. To prevent the spread of coronavirus, facilities have been closed to visitors for weeks and likely will be for months to come. That means no family members, friends, or volunteers may visit. But neither can state ombudsmen who advocate for residents. The federal government has stopped routine inspections of nursing facilities so it can focus on infection control and those hardest hit with COVID-19. On Friday, the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services issued new guidance for nursing facilities responding to coronavirus, but they were little more than suggestions for facilities and local authorities and included no additional resources. For example, CMS said it, quote, urges state and local leaders to consider the needs of long-term care facilities with respect to supplies of PPE, personal protective equipment, and COVID-19 tests. It also says, quote, nursing homes should ensure all staff are using appropriate PPE when they are interacting with patients and residents to the extent PPE is available and per CDC guidance on conservation of PPE. In the absence of masks, gloves, and gowns, what does this even mean? On Friday, the Associated Press reported 2,300 confirmed cases in long-term care facilities and 450 deaths, a staggering mortality rate of nearly 20%. Some nursing home medical directors think one-third of residents eventually could die of COVID-19-related illnesses. Having said that, nursing homes, assisted living facilities, as well as every staff member and resident are facing their biggest challenge in their history. Thank you very much for joining us on this COVID-19 report, and we'll see you next time.